Hello, Kennesaw. I'm Oliver.
And I'm Blake.
And this is Around the Mountain.
We've got so many great packages for you guys today, so you better stay tuned. If you were just planning on staying at home all alone during fall break because you didn't know what was going on in your community, well, Weekend Agenda is here to help.
Hey guys, I'm Tommy.
And I'm Julian.
And this is your fall break agenda. If you're hungry, you can come on down to downtown Kennesaw and get yourself some food for some food trucks.
Still hungry? You can come visit the Merida Square Market and enjoy many different great food experiences such as Tiny Bubble Tea Bar, Momosan Ramen, and Pita Mediterranean.
Hey guys, the North Georgia State Fair is open now, so make sure you go before it's over. Also, if you want volunteer hours for graduation, you can volunteer at Must Ministries and Mostly Mutts.
If you're looking for an adventure or a workout, you can always hike the mini trails of Kennesaw Mountain.
If you're looking for some sports, you can come down to SunTrust Park and watch the Braves take on the Royals September 24th and 25th, and watch them take on the Mets September 27th, 28th, and 29th. Also, stop by the Battery while you're at it for some great food and shops.
If you're not in the mood for baseball, you can head down to Mercedes-Benz Stadium and watch Atlanta United take on New York City Football Club on the 25th of September. And after that, on the 29th, we got the Falcons facing the Titans.
Guys, make sure you come out this weekend, September 22nd. Meek Mill and Future have a concert at the Lakewood Amphitheater, as well as Ugly God has a concert September 25th at the Masquerade. Make sure y'all come out.
Six Flags Fright Fest starts today, September 20th, so go get yourself in the Halloween mood by riding some roller coasters and going in some haunted houses. Also, take one last dip at Six Flags Whitewater, as this weekend is the last weekend of operation till next season.
As you can see, there's a lot to do around here for fall break. Be safe, have fun, and we'll see you back here next Monday.
Thanks for watching, Kennesaw.
I'm your phone that's going to distract you while you're driving. Buzz, 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 buzz.
Mayhem is everywhere, so get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Hey, Blake. You ever been hit by any kind of ball before?
Yeah, but luckily it was a pretty soft ball.
Here are a few highlights of our girls' softball team.
Gold.
I honestly think that when the pressure's on and you got the whole student section there and everyone's cheering you on, the main things that help us stay in control of the game is just knowing that the girls out there on the field are going to have your back and that you play for each other at the end of the day.
We started out 0-2, getting like blown out like 10-0, so we didn't really like have high hopes. We kind of turned it around and now we're like blowing teams out, so I feel like we've come a long way.
Congrats to our softball Lady Mustangs for their win over Hillgrove 10-7. Keep up the good work, ladies.
Whee! 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 Whee!
Tyler, we're here!
Oh, thanks, Mr. P.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico.
This year, KMHS has begun a new tradition honoring one amazing student every week. And here is the very first edition of Student of the Week for the school year.
With over 2,000 students calling the mountain their home,
it's hard to choose just one student of the month. This student is selected based on their portrayal of leadership, integrity, and determination both inside the classroom and out. This month, Javon Tatum, a top NJROTC leader and cadet commanding officer, was awarded this honor. Javon leads by example and sets the standard not only for more junior cadets, but for the entire student body. We recently spoke to Commander Pasco about Javon and her accomplishment.
Javon is a natural leader. She takes the time to get to know the people below her, and she inspires them to be better every day. So here at the ROTC unit, she's our commanding officer and essentially the leader of all of our cadets here. And pretty much every day, she makes them better. Yeah, I'm very proud of her. I think she's got a great future ahead of her in leadership, whether that's in the military or in the civilian world. She's going to continue to grow and lead, and that's what our country needs more than ever, our great leaders that are out there to lead this country. We need it more than ever these days.
You know, Commander Pasco put Javon's character into perfect words. Now, let's hear what Javon has to say about her accomplishment.
Student of the Month means that I was heavily active, I participate, I always try to do my best, I'm very motivated, and I participate and have a good attitude throughout the days. I'd like to thank Commander Pasco for nominating me for Student of the Month, and I'd like to thank everyone else who has supported me.
This has been Connor Wooten with KMTV, signing off.
So today's question is, why don't we remember our dreams? Well, let's get something straight, because I know what some of you were thinking. You're thinking, I don't even dream. Well, I'm telling you, you do. Everybody dreams every single night, multiple times a night. So why do we struggle to remember these vivid, often hallucinatory episodes of events running through our mind? I'll tell you, because it's actually not that important to what's going on in your brain. If somebody woke you up in the middle of a dream or right when you were finishing a dream, you would clearly remember what you were dreaming. But your brain knows in the morning, just that not important, just not important enough. You know what I'm trying to say. I'll tell you what you should be trying to remember. What's the plot of The Great Gatsby? The stages of mitosis. Your eights times tables, multiplication. That's the stuff you should be trying to remember, and leave the dreams to the Freudian psychoanalysts. And that's Dr. J's fun fact of the day.
Oliver, what better way is there to showcase this school's student body than with a survey?
I couldn't tell you, but here's a few students, so let's hear what they have to say.
How many movies can you name in 15 seconds?
John Wick, John Wick 2, John Wick 3, Avengers Endgame, Avengers Age of Ultron, Shrek,
Lone Survivor, My Little Mermaid, Princess and the Frog, Come on. Talladega Nights, we got, it's hard. How much time I got?
Alright, Fast and Furious, Too Fast, Too Furious, Fast and Furious 3, Tokyo Drift, Fast and Furious 4, Fast and Furious 5, Fast and Furious 6, Fast and Furious 7, Luke and Hobbs, Toy Story 1, Toy Story 2, Toy Story 3, Nemo,
The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, It 2, Halloween,
Casablanca, Star Wars, Return of the Jedi, Empire Strikes Back, Phantom Menace, Avengers Infinity Wars, Avengers Endgames, Iron Man, Ant-Man and Wasp.
Huh?
Home Alone, How the Grinch Stole Christmas, Harry Potter, The Greatest Showman, The Giver.
Mayhem is everywhere, so get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Hee hee.
You try.
Hee hee.
Oh, are you going?
Hee
hee. Wait, we're live.
Oh, sorry, we didn't see you there.
This is Face of the Week, Michael Jackson edition. That's the end of the show.
We'll be back in 2 weeks.
It's fall break next week.
It is fall break.
We won't see you.
No, we won't. Have a safe fall break.
We'll see you after.